الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وتوبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا صدق الله مولانا العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم صلاة وسلام عليك يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. Yesterday we talked about the importance of tawbah, the meaning of tawbah and the conditions of tawbah. Imam Ghazali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he now begins to mention about the excuses people make in regards to tawbah and why people, they do not go towards tawbah. The first and foremost reason why people don't do tawbah, he mentions, is because people do not find self-confidence when you do tawbah. If you do tawbah now, abhi maine tawbah kar li, ho sakta hai kal main wahi guna kar lu, phir se kya matlab maqsad. But if I do tawbah today, there's a possibility, mumkin, that tomorrow I will commit the same sin again. So what is the purpose and what is the point of the tawbah? Imam Ghazali radiallahu ta'ala says that this is one of the devil's deception. He wants you to stop doing tawbah, so he's going to say, okay, you're going to do tawbah today, but how sure are you, how confident are you that tomorrow you will not do the same sin again? Ye bahana ye shaitan ki taraf se hota hai. This is from shaitan. Ki aaj main tawbah karunga, ho sakta hai kal main wahi to guna kar lu. Ye khayal ye shaitan ki khayal hai. This is the shaitan's deception. That he doesn't give you that confidence that today I'm going to do tawbah, tomorrow I'm going to remain steadfast on my tawbah. So Imam Ghazali radiallahu ta'ala says, he'll always fight this fault. To ho sakta aaj maine tawbah kar li, ab kal meri maut waqi ho jaye. Ye bhi mumkin hai. It's a possibility that today I do tawbah and tomorrow I pass away. So if you do pass away tomorrow, so alhamdulillah, you passed away in the state of tawbah. And that's a blessing. Also, there's another possibility that tomorrow, inshallah, from tomorrow onwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the strength to remain mustaqeem on tawbah. Allah may give you istiqam on tawbah. So this is, again, Imam Ghazali says, there's always beauty of doing tawbah now. Forget the rest. Forget about the future. Don't worry about the future. Leave it in the divine hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the third thing, at least if you do tawbah today, all of your past sins will be forgiven. It's a new life, a new page, a new leaf for tomorrow. So at least, if you do commit sin tomorrow, but at least from today and the past, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of your past sins. So there's three blessings of doing tawbah today. If you do tawbah today, you might pass away tomorrow. So alhamdulillah, you pass away without any sins. And inshallah, from tomorrow, Allah may give you the strength, the ability to be steadfast on tawbah. That's a blessing. And third thing, at least, even if you go back to your normal routine, at least you have the tawbah for your past sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not penalize you, not punish you as regard to your past sins, because you've already the tawbah. And that's a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بہت اہم موضوع اور ایک نقطہ امام غزالی شاہ فرماتے ہیں कि गुनाह ये तीन तरह के होते हैं, the sins of three types. एक वो गुनाह के जिसने अल्लाह सुबहानहू व तआला वो फराइज कि अल्लाह सुबहानहू व तआला ने तुम्हें करने का हुक्म दिया था लेकिन आपने नहीं किए, जैसे नमाज, रोजे, हज, ज़कात वगैरह वगैरह. One type, there are three types of sin. This is very important for you to remember. One type of guna is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you certain obligations to fulfill, and yet you did not fulfill those obligations. For example, namaz. Every year you have to give zakat. Every year you have to fast a month of Ramadan, etc., etc. These are the fara'id. Now, how do you do tawbah? By doing qaza. You do qaza of namaz, you do qaza of the fast of Ramadan you missed in the previous years, and also give zakat of the previous years if you were liable to pay zakat and you did not pay zakat. So this is the first type of guna. And you see some of the guna that you have qaza to nahi hai, lekin sirf tawbah hai. The second type of guna is there's no qaza. For example, listen to music. Gana suna, kya usi koi qaza hoti hai? Of course not. Yes. Yes, so all you need to do is sincere tawbah. Yes. So if you did anything haram, but there's no qaza, all you need to do is sincere tawbah. Ya Allah, aaj se inshallah, main kabhi bhi guna, yani music, ya gana nahi sununga. Alhamdulillah. From today, inshallah, aaj se inshallah, main kabhi bhi haram cheez nahi khaunga, sharab nahi piunga. There's no qaza for these things. It's only sincere tawbah. You know the great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sharab nahi barha sunahu. Sayyidina, the great imam of Baghdad Sharif. Sayyidina Bishop Hafi radiallahu ta'ala. हाफी का मतलब बगैर जूते के नंगे पांव वाले, उसको हाफी कहते हैं अरबी में. सैयद बिशर हाफी रज़ियल्लाहु तआला अन्हु अपने वक्त के जलील कद्र वली, लेकिन उनकी तौबा भी मशहूर थी कि आप शराब नोश शराबी थे. बिशर हाफी रज़ियल्लाहु तआला अन्हु वाज एन अल्कोहलिक, ही वाज एडिक्टेड टू अल्कोहल. He cannot come off from alcohol. And once, इसी हालत में नशे के हालत में मस्त हो शराब के हालत में जा रहे थे बगदाद शरीफ की गलियों में. और देखो अल्लाह ताला जब चाहता है कि मेरा कोई बंदा तौबा करे तो क्या बहाना बनाता है. What excuse Allah make for that person? जा रहे थे तो रास्ते में देखा कि अल्लाह ताला के इसम गिरामी पर्चे पर एक कागज पर लिखा हुआ जमीन पर पड़ा हुआ है. He was drunk and is walking streets of Baghdad in the alleys of Baghdad. When he sees a piece of paper and written on a piece of paper was the name of Allah. He was drunk, but he was a Muslim. At least he had the decency to respect the name of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. हमने उस कागज को उठाया, उसको गुस्सा दिया और जेम्स एक दिरहम निकाला. दुकान में गए, एक इत्र को फरोख्त किया, उस पर इत्र लगाया, उस पर एक दीवार पर लगा दिया, अदब किया, रिस्पेक्ट किया. So he went to a shop, bought इत्र, perfume. He placed perfume around the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and placed a piece of paper on a wall. And then went to his house. And every night, his friends would come and they would be singing, listening to music, drinking alcohol. This was a norm of Bishop Hafi radiallahu ta'ala before tawbah. That very night, a great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw a dream, khwab dekha. Ki utho aur Bishop ko ye paigham sunao ki Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne unke tamam gunahon ko maaf farmaya. He saw a dream. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, wake up and go to Bishr and inform him Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven all of his previous sins. जब वो इमाम जो वो वली बेदार हुए तो सोचने लगे, कल रात उनके घर के पास में गया था तो गाने की आवाज में सुन रहा था, सब शराब नोश फरमा रहे थे, शायद ये झूठा काम है, probably it's a false dream. सो गए. Again, second time, he saw the same dream. Happened three times. ये ख्वाब आपने तीन मतलब देखा कि जाओ और मेरे बंदे मिश्र को ये पैगाम सुनाओ, खुशखबरी सुनाओ कि अल्लाह सुबहान व तआला उस तआज़ीम की बदौलत अल्लाह सुबहान व तआला ने उसके तमाम गुनाह को माफ फरमा दिया. Because of that one respect, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave all of his sins. Uthe, wuzu kiya, do rakat namaz padhi, phir wahan gaye, and then he knocked on the door. Now Bishr Hafi was a very rich man and used to have servants. The servant opened the door, khadim opened the door. Dekha ki ye jalqad imam alim, Bishr Hafi ke darwaze pe khade hai. Kaha kya paigham hai? Kaha Bishr ko ye paigham suna do कि उनके पास यानी मेरे पास एक अल्लाह का पैगाम आया हुआ है. Go and give him the message. I have a message for him from Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. The people were indulging, singing and dancing, listening to music, drinking alcohol. Says the servant went straight to Bishr Hafi radiallahu anhu, whispered in his ear that there's an imam waiting outside and he has a message for you from Allah. As soon as he heard that, Bishr Hafi radiallahu ta'ala, he ran outside. And when he went, he forgot to wear his shoes. Nange paav bahar tashreef le aaye. Imam sahab ne kaha, us wali kamil ne kaha, ye Bishr, wo kaun sa kaam kiya tha kal raat, jiske badal mujhe teen martaba Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne ishaara farmaya कि आपको ये खुशखबरी सुनाऊं कि अल्लाह सुभान व तआला ने तुम्हारे तमाम पीछे गुनाह को माफ फरमा दिया. व्हाट वाज दैट थिंग बिकॉज़ ऑफ व्हिच अल्लाह सुभान व तआला हैज सेंड मी 3,000 मैसेज टू इन्फॉर्म यू अल्लाह सुभान व तआला फॉरगिव ऑल ऑफ दिस. नाउ व्हेन ही केम आउट टू लिसन टू दिस मैसेज पैगाम, ही डिड नॉट हैव हिज शूज ऑन. ही फॉरगॉट टू हैव शूज बिकॉज़ इफ समवन वाज टू कम टू योर हाउस I said, there is a peygam for you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How would you feel? MashaAllah. Me in this state. I'm drinking, disobeying him. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent me a message. As soon as he heard that, he began to cry. And he repented in the hand of that wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aab se. Kabhi bhi gunah ki taraf nahi jaao. And he repented for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, from that day onwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from that moment he became the greatest wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one knew who Bishr was. He was an alcoholic. Bishr the alcoholic, Bishr the gunaygar, but today the Bishr the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know, from that day onwards, till his last breath, in order to remind him of the day when he repented, he never wore any shoes, any sandals. He used to walk in the street of Baghdad without shoes, without sandals. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him that maqam that even the animals would not urinate, would not spoil the streets of Baghdad Sharif out of respect of Bishr Hafi. The Bishr walks in this very particular city without shoes, that even the animals would not urinate in the street of Baghdad Sharif. And then there was a shepherd and was walking with a flock of sheep and cattle. When he saw that the sheep began to urinate in Sidi Baghdadi, he looked toward the sky. He said, Inna lillahi wa inna raji'un. It seemed as if today the great wali Bishr has passed away after many, many years. And they went to the house and he saw the many, many people crying because Bishr Hafi radiallahu ta'ala passed away. So from this we get to know that sincerity always needed. There are certain things we might disobey. This is haqq of Allah. So there are certain guna, if you commit, for example, if you don't pay namaz, you have to do qaza plus tawbah. If you don't fast a month of Ramadan, you have to do qaza of the fast of Ramadan plus tawbah. If you've not given zakat in previous years, or when you become baligh, qaza of those, zakat and tawbah. But then there are certain guna, certain sins, there's only tawbah, nothing else, there's no qaza. Only tawbah. And then The third and the most difficult one. سبسے اہم جس سے اکثر لوگ غافل ہوتے ہیں. Many people, you talk about month of 27 Ramadan, Ya Allah, please forgive me. Inshallah, I will not eat anything haram. I will not drink anything haram. I will stop paying my namaz. I will fast every year. I will give my zakat every year. That's easy. Of course, it's hard. It's hard to do tawbah. But in terms of what I'm going to mention, these two are easier. اور تیسری قسم وہ گناہ ہے جو تمہارے اور لوگوں کے درمیان ہے. And this is the most difficult one. A guna committed between you and other people, other creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ghazali رضی اللہ تعالیٰ says that یہ گناہ میں سب سے زیادہ اشد اور سب سے سنگین گناہ یہ تیسری قسم کا گناہ ہے. The most severe and the most difficult to repent from is the third category. It's because for this, Allah will not forgive you unless you go to the person, the victim of your guna, and you ask him to forgive you, then Allah will forgive you. اگر کسی کی غیبت کی نعوذ باللہ تو اللہ تعالیٰ اس وقت تک تمہارے گناہ نہیں معاف فرمائے گا جب تک آپ اس شخص کے پاس نہ جائے اور ان سے معافی طلب نہ کریں. Allah will not forgive you till you go to that person that you dishonored him through your words. You abused him physically, mentally, emotionally. Allah will not forgive you unless you seek forgiveness from those people. If you dishonor someone by backbiting or accuse him of a sin, then you need to seek the victim's forgiveness and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. And if this is not possible, اگر یہ ممکن ہی نہیں ہے جیسے کہ for example آپ نے کسی کی غیبت کی اور ان سے معافی طلب کرنے سے پہلے ان کا انتقال ہو گیا آپ کیا کریں if you did a غیبہ and that person and that for example this Ramadan you want to change now inshallah this Ramadan will change now you go back to every individual you remember who accused him I went to that person, I did the ghibah of this person, that person. But what if the person passed away? اگر ان کا انتقال ہو گیا تو میں معافی کیسے طلب کریں گے؟ How are you going to seek forgiveness? تو پھر اشد اب یہ معاملہ آپ کے اور اللہ کے درمیان ہے کہ کل بروز قیامت یہی شخص آپ سے آپ کے نیک اعمال لے جائے گا. تو امام غزالی فرماتے ہیں اگر یہ ممکن نہیں ہے ان کے پاس جا کے آپ معافی طلب کر سکے کیونکہ انتقال ہو گیا چلے گئے یا گم ہو گیا تو اب آپ نیک عمل میں زیادتی کریں increase the good deeds صدقات خیرات نوافل روزے اور زیادہ کریں تاکہ کل بروز قیامت یہی اعمال ان کو لیے جائیں گے because these good deeds will be given to him and if you do not have any good deeds then his bad deeds will be given to you and you will be thrown into the hellfire. This is the enormity of the huquq of ibadah and that is why there's a hadith. Hadith Sharif ka mafhoom hai ki Huzur sallallahu ta'ala se irshad farmaya sahabe kiram se ke mere sahabiyo ki zina se badtar ghibat hai which is worse crime than adultery is backbiting, ghiba. Why is that? اس وجہ سے کوئی نے زنا کر لیا سرزد ہو گیا گناہ کر لیا تو معافی طلب کر لیا اللہ میں معافی چاہتا ہوں آج سے انشاءاللہ میں زنا نہیں کروں گا اللہ تعالیٰ معاف فرمائے گا لیکن ghiba ایسا گناہ ہے کہ جب تک وہ مظلوم وہ معاف نہیں فرمائے گا اس وقت تک اللہ تمہارے گناہ معاف نہیں فرمائے گا As long as the person does not ask for forgiveness or does not forgive you, Allah will not forgive you. So which is a greater crime? Ghibah. And look up, apni community mein dekhe. Jab hum saath mein hote hain, doston ke saath, when we are in the car, when we are outside the masjid, when we are eating with our family, when you are outside on the street, when we are even in the masjid, what is our conversation about? Na'udhu billah. What is our conversation about? اس کی بلا برائی کرنا اس کی غیبت کرنا اس کی چغلی کرنا یہ کرنا وہ کرنا Okay, most of our conversation, illa mashallah, most of our conversation, we're not with our friends. Okay, we're not with our religious circles. Okay, most of our conversation is about talking about him. Us imam ki ghibat karna, us shakhs ki ghibat karna, us gula ki ghibat karna. This is majority of our ghiba. And do you know ghiba? Sirf zaban se nahi hoti, ishaare se bhi ghibat ho sakti hai. But it's not verbally, even through indications of ghiba. For example, masala, koi chal raha ho, masjid mein aaya. Usse chalne mein takleef hai, he cannot walk properly. He's got disability. Aapne dost se ye ishaara kiya. This is also part of ghiba. Yes? If someone can't walk properly, for example, he can't speak properly. Okay, he's got deficiency in any of his whatever physical or spiritual, maybe, or emotional. Like he cannot speak properly, he cannot think properly, he's got weak memory, anything, he has a defect. Okay? So you indicate isharatan. And then you smile. Yeah. This is also classes of ghiba. This is also classes of ghiba. Imam Shalushani mentioned the three types of ghiba. One is verbal. He can't even walk. Okay, this is verbal. Second is, and it happens especially with children. There's a person walking on the street. You walk behind, walk like him. To make a mockery. Okay, this is a physical ghiba. And the third is ishara. He can walk properly, he cannot even speak properly, he cannot, whatever, he cannot do properly. This is also part of ghiba. Now imagine ourselves now. Okay, how many others were involved in this sin? Without any hesitation. Without any hesitation, shuru kari. This is like a play button. Okay? But once you've done ghiba, like once it's gone now. Yeah? This is very difficult. Ghiba is one of the worst. That is why in the community of Madinah Munawwara, the Prophet ﷺ hated those individuals who in front of him did ghiba by other individuals. Ghiba sunnah bhi, ye ghiba na shamil hai. Even to listen to ghiba is very difficult. Koi ghibat kar aapke samne bahut mushkil hota hai ki please mere samne bazoo ki video na ye bahut mushkil hai. Okay, you should try and divert the conversation. Chalo maaf karo bichara bimar hai kamzori, you can do that, but it's very difficult. It's very difficult. Please mere samne bazoo ki video na kare, because even both will get adab. Ghibat karne wala aur ghibat sunne wala dono ye ek equal, they are both equal in terms of guna. Okay, so this is very important for us to remember. Imam Ghazali radiallahu ta'ala says that this valley is very difficult to cross. Okay, agar be namazi the, namazi ho gaye, aasan ho gaya. Okay, sharab peete the, sharab se tauba karni ye aasan hai. Lekin kisi ki ghibat ki tuhmat lagaya, kisi ka maal churaya, वगैरह अब माफी तलब करना बहुत दुश्वार चीज है. The most difficult is to go to a person and say please, especially to the ghiba of an alim, of an imam, okay, of a scholar of deen, because very difficult for you to go to a scholar, please. And then ghibat का मतलब ये नहीं कि उनके पास जब मैंने आपकी ghibat की थी please मुझे माफ कर दीजिए, ये नहीं. उनको ये बताना ये ghibat की थी, उनको बताना भी है जरूरी. गिबत के लिए ये भी जरूरी है, ये फला चीज मैंने आपके हवाले से मैंने कहा था. सी कैन आई गिव पीपल गो टू हज एंड से प्लीज माफ कीजिए, अगर इफ आई सेड समथिंग प्लीज फॉरगिव मी, ये माफी नहीं है. यू नो पीपल सेंड अ टेक्स्ट मैसेज, ओह इट्स अ लेटर कदर, इफ फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई हैव हार्म यू और इफ आई अब्यूज यू, इफ आई डिड प्लीज फॉरगिव मी, दिस इज नॉट इनफ टू डू टेक्स्ट मैसेज, ओह वेरी प्लीज फॉरगिव मी, बोल पुलिस के माफ पीपल से before Allah, will you change your mind? But you know you did ghiba. This is not even, okay, with Imam Ghazali, they later say, this is not ghiba, this is not forgiveness. You have to go, please, brother, I said to you about you, that, you know, you do not know how to walk. Or the way you sit Okay, I made a mockery. You know, I don't like the way you blink eyes. I'm making it up. Yeah, I don't like the way you wear your shoes. Any smallest amount of ghibah, he did, and they were known about it. This is, you have to tell them the ghibah. Then I will say to them, whether to forgive you or not to forgive you. Okay, so it's not easy. It's not easy, especially in our Gujarati community. Yeah, the Gujarati community works. The top one, from top 10 in all the community of the world, I think we will be the top in ghibah. it's true. We'll be the top one. Okay? We are the only one. Okay? You want to say, you want to do this, and you must say, do everything. Imam said, ye kana, wo kana, and happening in the middle. बोलने में सबसे आगे लेकिन कहने में सबसे पीछे. Okay, we are, I'm talking because we grew up in this community and I've visited many communities, especially Arabs. You know, alhamdulillah, when you look at Arabs, okay, they'll fight each other and then they'll forgive. I mean, in Egypt, you'll see that even the actions happen, they'll come out, they'll argue, they'll fight, and then immediately they'll come, they'll forgive, and that's it, subhanAllah, they'll go. Okay, but we keep it in our hearts. Even after forgiveness, we're going to keep it. We'll keep you, you know. He came to me yesterday, he said he did my ghibah. I hate him now. Even though he came to you for forgiveness, but no. Why did you do ghibah? Okay? So you're gonna keep it all your life. Yeah, this is the mentality we have. Okay, this is the grudge we keep in our heart for no reason. It's gonna spoil you emotionally, spiritually it's gonna spoil you, you cannot pray properly, it's always jealousy just there, and then you're just constantly thinking about that guy. I'm gonna get one day, or once I get a chance, I'm gonna go to him, I'm gonna grab his neck and push him to the wall and say, you. Yeah? But you never get a chance to do it because we are soft. Gucci's always think a lot. But when it's time to, you know, for example, when in school, I don't talk about school, shouldn't you? But remember, it's all about chatting. Me and you outside, yeah, outside. And you'll be the one, first one running off. Okay? But anyway, this is our state. But anyway, what Imam Ghazali radiallahu was saying is the third guna, sabse ashad. Sabse sangheer guna, ye third asim. Jisi kisma ka guna. Inshallah, and how to do repentance, inshallah, we're going to talk about this later on. A very important topic, inshallah. I'm going to finish off the topic of Tawbah, inshallah, tomorrow. And then, inshallah, how to do sincere Tawbah. Tawbah, kaise ki jati hai? What is the practical method of doing Tawbah? Okay, how do you do tawbah? And what do you think about when you do tawbah? How do you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for tawbah, inshallah? We cover all these points, inshallah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina maulana Muhammad wa ala ala sayyidina maulana Muhammad wa sallam. One thing, remember, I'm getting insha, talafuza insha'Allah. Not inshallah. Bazu inshallah. The talafuz inch in, if. Sha'a, Jaha, Allah ne chaha to. Agar Allah ne chaha. In means if, Sha'a will, Allah. Insha'Allah. Ye talafuz hai. Insha'Allah. Insha'Allah nahi. Insha'Allah bhi nahi. Insha'Allah to malum hai uska matlab kya hai. Okay? But in, na'udhu billah, insha'a, sa'a, 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 sa'a in Arabic, sa'a means do something bad. Sa'a ka matlab, kharab cheez karna. It's a sa'a, yasu, sa'a. Okay? So in sa'a, means to kufar. You don't want to lie to each. Okay, for example, rakume, jab hum rakume hote hain, ek masla aur samajh farma rakume, barish mein ye masla hai. Agar aapko subhan rabbi al azim, ye aapko mushkil, talaffuz karna ye mushkil hai aapke liye. Subhan rabbi al azim, ye wa hai na zoi, hum kehte hain mushkil zoi, wa zoi yani lam. Zoi in Arabic is tip of the tongue, touching the teeth. Allah. Azim. Azim. Okay. If it's difficult, then you'll say, Subhan Rabbi al-Kareem. Kareem is easy, Kareem. Kareem is going to do it. Subhan Rabbi al-Kareem. So, if you don't say Subhan Rabbi al-Azim, some people say Subhan Rabbi al-Ajim. Astaghfirullah. Okay? So, Subhan Rabbi al-Azim. Allah. Okay, if you cannot say Allah, okay, if you say Azim or Ajim, Ajim is Astaghfirullah, it means a person can't speak. Dumb, Ajam. Arab wal Ajam, Al Arabi wal Ajami. In the Because Ajam, Ajim means a person who can speak. So you say, Ra'aytu to my Lord who is, A'udhu Billah, is kufr. Okay, of course it's not because you don't know, so you know, because as acting kufr, but it's tawbah, you need to be tawbah. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Agar yeh mushkil hai, to aap kahenge Subhana Rabbi al-Kareem. Agar khamush nahi rahe, namaz bhi koi kharabi nahi aayegi. Because Subhana Rabbi al-Azim kehna yeh sunnat hai, agar sunnat nahi ki aapne namaz adab ho jayegi. Okay, even if you don't say anything, ruku, Allahu Akbar. If you don't say anything behind the imam, it's fine. Okay? Same with at-tahiyyat. People say at-tahiyyat, at-tahiyyat. What's at-tahiyyat? At-tahiyyat. Okay? At-tahiyyat. So at-tahiyyat. So there's all these wrong things in Sheikh. So I was talking about insha'Allah. Because insha'Allah tomorrow. So insha'Allah. Insha'Allah. You are saying it? Insha'Allah. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا محمد واصحابه وبارك وسلم اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتوب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا كريم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم بفضل سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.